Welcome to the iRoofing training tutorial. I'm Kyle, the lead trainer here at iRoofing, and today we're going to be doing a training on an advanced measurement. So we'll begin by tapping where it says measure your roof and hitting sketch my roof. And in this instance, we're actually going to be measuring from our own imagery. The application actually allows you to measure from both a drone image and a blueprint or any other image you might have on your device. We will start by first tapping on the load button at the bottom of the screen, which is right next to your search bar. Then you'll hit load drawing in the bottom left hand corner. And then you'll be able to select a source from where you'd like to load your image. In this case, I can go into my Google Drive account. Once I'm in my Google Drive account, I can now choose any PDF document that I have for a blueprint or any JPEG photo that I've got for a drone photo. If I were to go to my roof plans folder, for example, and select one of my blueprints that I have, it will load up a preview of that document for me. If it's a multiple page document, I can then select which page I'd like to measure from. Tap on the image and hit done up in the top left hand corner. And now it's going to load that image into the measurement section of the app for me, and I can measure directly off of this image. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that when you're measuring from your own imagery, due to the fact that you're no longer using satellite, the application has no way to determine distance for you automatically. So in this case, after we finish drawing out an area of the roof, we would need to use Scale Verify at the bottom of our screen to set the scale for our photo. So as an example, I'm going to draw the slope of the roof here. And after I've completed the slope, I will then use my Scale Verify feature to set the length of one of my lines, and in return, set the scale for the entire image. So let's say, for example, that this ridge here happened to be 23 feet. I'll tap on Scale Verify at the bottom, tap on that line, and type in 23 feet. And once I hit OK, that will give me all of my measurements for that area. So using just that one line sets my scale for my photo, and I can measure accurately off of my blueprint. Now I'm going to hit the back arrow in the bottom left hand corner, and I want to go back to my search screen. Next to my search bar, I'll hit load once again, load drawing in the bottom left hand corner, go into my Google Drive, and in this case, I'm going to go into my drone folder. Once I've gone into my drone folder, I can then select an image that I've got by tapping on the image to view a preview. And I want to find the image that I'd like to use here, so I'm going to cycle through the images that I've got. After selecting my image, I can hit the check mark up at the top of the screen and measure directly from my drone photo. Now with this particular image, we have an area to the front where we have an overhang. What I want to do is start by measuring my area of the roof that lies on top. So I'll start by measuring that valley there. Then up that hip to this ridge, across the ridge to these hips, down the hip and onto this corner, and then back over to my starting point. Now to do the opposite area, I need to get underneath the eave that I just drew. But you'll notice that when I bring my crosshair on the inside of a completed area and I let go, I always get pushed to the outside. So in this case, what I would need to do is place and hold my crosshair down on top of that dot. And without moving my crosshair, now I need to place and hold my finger within this area of the roof until the entire area starts to flash green. Then from there, what I'll do is drag the area over to the side and then use my marker button to place down a new point on the same spot. And when I hit the marker button, it registered my crosshair sitting on top of the previous dot. So what I need to do is hit undo up in the top right corner and hit marker again to create a new point. From here, I'll do my overhang. So I want to go down, say about a foot or two, underneath that eave, place down a point, and then go over to my right, line up with that eave, and then work my way around that slope of the roof. The hip to my ridge, across the ridge to my valley, then down the valley back to my starting point to shade the area. Now I'll also need to label my parts while I still have the roof separated, so this way I can tell which lines belong to which area. So I'll tap on label parts down in the bottom right, and then begin to label each of my parts that I've created so far. I will also need to label the areas of the roof that were separated, so that valley, for example, would need to be labeled on both slopes. So this way, when I put the two pieces of the roof back together, I don't end up with a double measurement for that line because they'll both register as the same valley. So now I'll label my eaves there, my hip over here, got a little rake right here, and then I also have my flashing and any step flashing underneath that eave there. After drawing that out, I'll then go back to the measure button, place and hold my finger within this area to drag it back over, and I need to reconnect my lines for this area. Once I've got the two areas sitting on top of each other again, lift off the screen, and that's going to snap back into place, giving me only one measurement for that valley there. So when I use Scale Verify to set my scale, let's just say that the line here happens to be 15 feet, you'll see that we only have one measurement for that valley there. So from here, I'm going to hit measure again, and I can continue measuring the roof as I normally would. So after drawing out each of my areas, I can continue by labeling the parts that I just created. So I'll go to label parts again, label the rest of my hips, do the rest of my eaves, and that should cover everything. Now my final step would be to set the pitch for my roof. Since I have a drone photo here, I don't have any way of looking at the street view, but while you're at the property, you'll always want to make sure that while you're taking that one measurement to use to verify your scale, you'll also want to take note of the pitch of the roof as well. Let's go to pitch down at the bottom, and let's say that this roof is going to be a 6x12. So I'll select the number 6 over to the right, tap within each area on the roof. That will set the pitch for those areas, and then I can tap on report down at the bottom to generate my report. So we'll hit save. Let's save this to John Smith. Tap on OK. And with this roof set as 6x12, we have a total of 10 squares. Go down to our second page, we have our diagram, and you can see on our diagram the area where we have the overhang, the lines are crossing over each other like we want them to. And continue scrolling down, and we can see that we've got our comprehensive report along with our area sitting underneath that eave. And from there, just like with our other reports, we can hit share, and then print it out, email it, or upload it to Dropbox or Google Drive. Now when I hit measure in the bottom right, you can see how we have a few vents on the roof as well. So if I wanted to cut those out and label those vents, I can hit subtract on the right side of the screen. And I can also trace around these vents to measure the perimeter of these as well. This way we get our flashing measurements for all our vents. Then I can go to label parts, label that as flashing if I'd like. Alright, so that concludes the advanced tutorial for our measurement tool. Now you've seen how you can also do overhangs and move areas around, and also how to use subtract to cut objects out of the roof.